Again, please welcome, please join me in welcoming the Ashland High School faculty. Good afternoon and welcome. It is my great pleasure to introduce the 142nd graduating class of Ashland High School, the class of 2015. I ask that we all please rise.
Thank you.
Please remain standing. Gentlemen, remove your hats as members of the Ashland High School Chorus sing the national anthem. Good afternoon, and again, welcome to the graduation exercises for the class of 2015. This is an exciting day for all, and on behalf of Ashland High School, I welcome all family members, scholarship donors, and guests to our ceremony today. I offer a special welcome and thank you to all the parents in the audience. Your love, commitment, and support have shaped the students that sit before us into wonderful young men and women. I would also like to thank the Ashland School Committee, past and present, and the entire Ashland community. We cannot thank you enough for your ongoing support. Let me also thank all of the military and first responders, current and retired, in the audience. Please stand for a moment and be recognized. Your service and commitment to this country helps to ensure we have the opportunity to offer a free and appropriate education to all children in Ashland, and for that we thank you. Next, I would ask that all current, retired, and past educators of the Ashland Public Schools, including administrators, central office staff, nurses, custodians, maintenance, and nutrition services, to stand. You work on a daily basis to make the lives of the children in Ashland better. Without your commitment, Ashland students would not have access to the amazing education that they have been afforded. Finally, a huge thank you to the people who have made sure the preparations for this day have gone smoothly. Mrs. Hunter, Mrs. Cheney, Mrs. Diamond, Mrs. Duane, Mr. Mostow, the class advisor, Mr. McGann, our diploma name reader, Mr. Mall, Ms. Mercadante, Mr. Rund, Mr. Mortensen, and the rest of the custodial and maintenance departments. Thank you so much for making sure I knew what I was doing this week. The students sitting before you today are special. Ask anyone in this building. Had I kept track this year of how often someone said, "This is such a great or special class," I could be rich. Over the course of the year, I've kept notes on what I would say today. And as I sat down this week to review these notes and look at what others were saying about the class of 2015, the theme was amazingly consistent. A couple of weeks ago, I asked Emily Cooper, the class president, "What one word would you use to describe this class?" Her response, remember? Kind. Kind. This is what makes them special. Their genuine kindness and commitment to each other and to the world around them is something that I have never seen in my 17 years working in a high school. We learned on class day that they completed 2,000 more hours, over 2,000 more hours of community service than the previous class. And an impressive feat, given the hours that each graduating class from Ashland High School gives back has risen every year. You are a group of students who value service to your community. So as I thought about what to say to you today, I was at a loss. You are already people who do things that make for a truly valuable and fulfilling life. You think of others first. So I have two thoughts or challenges for you as you move on to the next stage of your life. I hope that each and every student in this class continues to make sure you are part of a community. It does not matter where, just make sure wherever you are, you find your community. They will change many times over the course of your lives. Embrace that. Keep connected to previous communities and grow with your new ones. And whatever you are part of, make sure you find a way to give back. If for some reason you don't feel you are part of a community, speak up, let someone know, and move on if you need to. There is always a place you belong, and you do not have to be part of a group that you don't feel good about. My second challenge is to do your best to continue to be kind to everyone. Find friendships and connections that you can commit to and allow you to be your true self. Question if your friends would do for you as you would do for them. If they would, they are true friends. You will have all kinds of jobs, careers, but the relationships you build are what matters in life. And you deserve to have people who are kind to you, respect you, and will always do what is right by you. I hope you are lucky enough to maintain the friendships you have created the past 12 years for the rest of your life. But make an effort to build new relationships, step out of your comfort zone, and be kind to someone you might not think to befriend. This class has done that within the halls of AHS. Remind yourself to do that in the colleges and workplaces you move on to, regardless of what others are doing. As I sat reading the yearbooks Friday night at the senior banquet, I couldn't help but think about what my hopes and dreams were as I graduated from high school. So yesterday I pulled out my yearbook and blew off a big pile of dust. I was going to marry a millionaire and spend my life on my own private tropical island, while also being a powerful lawyer in Washington, D.C., who changes the world. Those dreams, needless to say, did not happen in the exact way I hoped. Just as some of the goals I read in the class of 2015 yearbook may not play out the way they are written. Several of you wrote you hope to marry rich. But as it turns out, I am a very rich person. I am rich because I am doing something I love every day, with people that make me smile and laugh, people that challenge me in good ways, and people that help me be a better person and give me opportunities to give back to the world I live in. I also spend a lot of time in the Cape, which is the beach, even if it's not tropical. This is what I would hope for you. Dreams change and grow. I hope you hold on to the dreams you have today and let them grow and change with you. I challenge you to hold on to who you are today, kind people who find service to others a priority. A much-loved employee of Ashland Public Schools, Tony Vaccaro, had the mantra, because nice matters. I encourage you to all take that as your own. I hope in 30 years, when you look back on high school and you were able to, that you are able to say that you still give back to your community and that you still have a kind group of diverse friends. That, to me, is a rich life. I would now like to introduce our superintendent of schools, James Adams.
We did not sit and write our speeches together, just so you know ahead of time. But there are many running themes that you'll hear from me that Ms. St. Kerr just mentioned as well. So let me begin by saying good afternoon and congratulations to the class of 2015. As many have done before me and will continue to do, I'd like to thank a number of individuals and organizations. First, thank you to the school committee for providing me with the most humbling and rewarding of jobs. I'm honored to be the superintendent of schools here in Ashland. Thank you to Ms. St. Kerr for her steadfast leadership here at Ashland High School. Thank you to the entire faculty and staff from pre-K through grade 12. You are one of the most fantastic staffs anyone could work with. Thank you to the Board of Selectmen, Finance Committee, and the entire community for providing our schools with the necessary resources to assist our youngest and most precious resource, our kids. And finally, thank you to the class of 2015 for continuing to show me what it means to be a loving, caring, and welcoming community. I was hesitant to write a speech for this event. In fact, I only decided to write one last night. This day is about you, not me. And as I have stated in prior speeches, you're already tuning me out and silently saying, hurry up, Mr. Adams, we've got better things to do. And to quote one of my favorite artists, Nelly, it's getting hot in here. I could not agree more. I remember, as I was looking through my yearbook as well last night, sitting in the hot sun outside of my high school, listening to the speeches of the superintendent, the principal, etc. Guess what? The only thing I remember was it was hot. So I will keep this very brief. I don't believe I can teach you how to act, treat one another, or become something bigger than oneself in this single speech. What I do now is that it is, what I do now, see, I didn't edit this. This is when you write at the last minute. What I do know now is that it is you, the entire class of 2015, that has taught me how to act, how to treat one another, and how to become part of something bigger than myself. You've taught me what it is like to band together when times are tough. For example, and as Emily mentioned on Friday, when, yes, I canceled the Powder Puff game a year ago, you didn't come to me and complain. Well, maybe just a little bit. Rather, you came to me and said, what can we do to get the game back? You showed leadership and understanding of why I was not in favor of the game, and you made it better, community-centered, and more focused on doing good. When Ms. St. Kerr brought the idea forward to me, all I could do was smile and say, they just get it. Your respect and acceptance of not only all of your classmates, but for the entire student population is a model of behavior which every student at Ashland High School should strive for. Lining the halls, celebrating our Special Olympian athletes, being inclusive and celebrating our diversity continuously are prime examples of this. I am so proud of all of you and how you treat one another. Your dedication to the community through the thousands of hours of service is not only remarkable, but shows that giving back is one of the greatest joys in life. We are truly a community here in Ashland. I did not know what to expect when I left AHS to take the superintendent's position in August. I knew I would miss all of you. Your constant smiles, positive attitude. But what I said to Ms. St. Kerr on numerous times, that this is truly one of the most special classes ever to walk the halls of AHS. You all get along. There's little to no drama. You care for one another. And you go out of your way to always do what is right. You embodied and embody what we envisioned 6 years ago when we created the core values of Ashland High School. I thank you for that. To conclude, I would like to impress upon you to remember your roots and to continue to give back. Our world is ever-changing, and it will take individuals like you to ensure that our future generations have the same opportunities that you all have had. Keep this community in your hearts, but go out and make the world a better place, as you have done here in Ashland and at Ashland High School. You are truly a special group of students, and I've been honored to watch you grow these past 4 years. I am deeply indebted to your leadership, your commitment to excellence, your acceptance for all, and for teaching what it means to be a clocker. Best wishes to all of you in your future endeavors. Thank you.
I'm going to keep a tradition alive of going off program. So as we are getting ready to hear a selection from the chorus, Mr. Adams mentioned our core values, which are very important here at Ashland High School. On Friday, we awarded graduation cords to 5 seniors that the faculty nominated and voted on to represent, be model students of those core values. So I would ask them to stand now as I read their name. The graduation cord for the value respect went to Miguel Franco. The cord for responsibility went to Katie Spielberger. The cord for integrity went to Emily Murray. The cord for involvement went to Anna Weisgerber. And the cord for achievement went to Emily Cooper. And at this time, I invite members of the Ashland High School Chorus forward to perform a song for you. Thank you. That was beautiful. I now invite Ani Moore to deliver her salutatorian address.
Welcome, fellow students, family, friends, teachers, administrators, and supporters of the class of 2015. Even though you may not hear it enough from us, thank you. It is all of you that have provided the support, motivation, and nagging that has gotten us here today. Now, we all knew that Anna Essenther would be our valedictorian. The gap between her and the rest of the class was way too big for anyone else to have a chance. But being the class of 2015 salutatorian was a bit of a surprise. To be honest, I thought there were too many other brilliant people in the class to compete with to get this far. Although, as much as it is an honor to be up here, I do have to say that writing one last speech while the rest of the class was completely free of assignment to read in front of hundreds of people was not quite my idea of a reward. As if a prize for 4 years of hard work was more work. Now, I will warn you that I don't have a great attention span when it comes to listening to speeches myself, so I'm gonna keep this short. As many of you know, my mom's not from here. She never went to high school in America, so her idea of high school was often based off of scenes in movies where one group ruled the school and cheerleaders wore their uniforms to school every day. But when she'd ask me about school here in Ashland, I could proudly say that Ashland High School was better than the movies. Although there were no musical numbers in the cafeteria, as some people hoped, there were no nasty cliques or exclusivity that is often portrayed between students either. No malicious teachers out to get you, although maybe we'd like to think so. No major fights. Everyone had their friend groups, yeah, but it was never uncommon for people to mingle between them without a second thought. It was like a second home with a second family I've grown up with for 12 years. As I grew up and conquered my own fears, I loved to watch others conquer theirs and to be able to see the difference between then and now. Remember those fifth grade yearbooks we all like to say we burned? Well, at least they're proof that we've all improved. Even though our senior week t-shirts this year said finished, and we're all excited to get out of here, we all know that we're not really finished. There's more work to do and more fears to conquer beyond this building. I know each one of you has the potential to achieve far beyond what has been accomplished in the last 4 years, whether that means entering the workforce, continuing your education, or taking a break to discover yourself. The world is full of challenges, but we've been prepared for them. The real question is the world prepared for us? Thank you and good luck to you all.
And next, I'm very pleased to invite to the podium Anna Essenther, this year's valedictorian.
Fellow graduates, administrators, teachers, family, and friends, we take it for granted that the Ashland High School class of 2015 will go on to do great things. The potential that resides in each of the accomplished individuals you see before you today is remarkable. I know that my friends and classmates will pursue their passions as architects and actuaries, carpenters and cryptographers, economists and engineers. We'll obtain success through myriad means. We'll impress professors and employers and we'll change the world and all that. But what if that weren't the assumption? What if we didn't have access to the teachers, counselors, classes, textbooks, advice, and resources that have made our future success seem inevitable? I'd like to take a moment to thank everyone to whom we graduates are indebted for getting us to where we are today. First and foremost, thank you to our teachers for your lucid explanations of everything from fractions to integration by parts, for your patience, often unmerited, and above all, for your devotion to your jobs, which you never treated as just a job. There are many other people I could list that have contributed to our collective success, some of whom we share in common, but many who are personal. Just know that we are grateful for whatever role you played. So, thanks to all of you, we're here today, ready to graduate and go to college, start a career, or serve our country. Or maybe not ready. I'm only 17 years old, and I know that many of my classmates will agree when I say that the thought of being a real adult seems daunting. We're constantly being asked what our future plans are, and we're expected to respond articulately and intelligently about what we're going to do with our lives. But what if we don't know? Don't panic if you haven't chosen a major yet, or you don't know what you'll be doing when you're 30. You're young and have plenty of time to figure it all out, and then change your mind and figure it all out again. But never use your youth as an excuse to slide by, do the minimum, claim that you'll be productive sometime in the vague future. Do stuff now. Make a plan, even if you change it. Join a club, even if you end up dropping it. Apply for jobs, internships, and volunteer positions, even if you're not sure how they'll relate to your future career. Know that your activities are very much worthwhile, even if they don't end up on your resume. According to Horace Mann, a Massachusetts native and founder of the public education system, a human being is not attaining his full heights until he is educated. So educate yourselves in whatever form that may take for you. You know your own weaknesses and gaps in your education. Why not address them? Don't know how to jumpstart a car? Unsure of your professional writing skills? Scared of using your oven? Learn. Your youth, far from an excuse to do nothing, is an invitation to do everything. The next time somebody asks you what your plans for the future are, say you plan to be smarter and more skilled than you are now, and that you plan to fix problems, make your voice heard, and instill in others a spirit of service like you yourself have, and kindle their potential like our teachers, parents, and friends have kindled ours. So, class of 2015, I challenge you. Become successful doctors, engineers, and politicians, but also become bibliophiles, autodidacts, philanthropists, and humanitarians. Join Doctors Without Borders, engineer solutions to the problems of the modern age, write bills and books to advocate reform. Learn to love learning, express gratitude for your education, and improve yourselves and your society.
We are about to go off program again. We had a beautiful performance on class day that we would like to hear one more time and share with this audience. So at this time, I ask Emily Dunn and Aaron Keaveney to come to perform.
Said that people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes a sun, like a stream that meets boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better, but because I knew you, I have been changed for good.
It well may be that we will never meet again in this lifetime. But let me say before we part, so much of me is made of what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart. So now whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea, like a seed dropped by a sky bird in a distant wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? Because I knew you.
Because I knew you.
I have been changed for good. And just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for.
But then I guess we know there's blame to share.
And none of it seems to matter anymore.
Like a comet,
like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea.
Like a stream,
like a sea drop by a sky bird in the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? I do believe I have been changed for the better. Because I knew you.
Because I knew you.
Because I knew you. I have been changed for good.
That was beautiful, ladies. Thank you very much. I do want to do another reminder that if you are feeling the heat, we do have the auditorium air conditioned, and the ceremony is streaming in there. At this time, I would like to invite School Committee Chair Lori Tosti to the podium.
Good afternoon, graduates, parents, and guests, faculty, our superintendent, administrators, members of the Board of Selectmen, town and government officials. It's an honor and a privilege to be with you here today as you celebrate this milestone. I speak on behalf of the entire school committee in saying that we are so proud to serve in a community that includes students like all of you, who are each very special in your own way. No, I did not collaborate with Mr. Adams or Ms. St. Kerr on the speech. There seems to be a running theme here today, and I also wasn't aware that how this class is known for its kindness, and that just really makes me, and I know the other members of the school committee, so proud, because it's a value that we embody, and we're so proud to work with people that also embody that as a value. And I did want to say a few words about it myself today, but I'll start with saying to parents and families, we can't thank you enough for all the different ways that you support Ashland Public Schools. It's truly a team effort to reach this day where we are all beaming with pride over the accomplishments of these amazing students that have consistently put Ashland at the top of many impressive lists. I know we will continue to work together to make sure we can provide a first-rate education to all the students who will follow. To the graduates, I've been lucky enough to be given this opportunity to speak with you today. And I'd like to share with you just a few of the most important things I can think of to say to you on the day that you graduate from high school. They're all pretty simple, and they're reminders, really. I know that you know this. But one thing I want you to know, really, truly know, is that you matter, every single one of you, regardless of where you're from, what you've done, what's happened, where you're going next, what you've accomplished or not, you matter. Something that I hope you will do as you move forward, take the time every single day to remind somebody else that they matter. And I know you'll do this because I've heard about how kind you all are. And it really doesn't take much, you know that. There are thousands of different ways to do this. As Maya Angelou said, be a rainbow in somebody else's cloud. Every day, be a rainbow in somebody else's cloud, and you will lead a more fulfilling life if you take the time to make a difference. And last but not least, be yourself. Go after your dreams. Follow your heart. Chase your goals. Don't worry about who's doing what, or what anyone else thinks, as you pursue what's meant for you and only you. E.E. Cummings said, to be nobody but yourself in a world which is doing its best night and day to make you everybody else means to fight the hardest battle which any human being can fight and never stop fighting. Trust your inner guidance and just do you. So as you get ready to enter this next very exciting phase of life, remember how truly special and unique you all are. Remember, you have the power to make a difference and be the best version of you that you can be. Shine your lights, expect great things. Congratulations to the class of 2015.
Thank you, Mrs. Tosti. Each year, the class chooses a faculty member that they would like to have address them. This year, they have chosen Mr. Michael Worster, and I invite him to the stage.
Graduates, families, friends, and all those plus ones out there who were dragged here today with the promise of cake, welcome. I just want to go off book here and say, if you thought I was going to cry today, folks, you know, and you have the ringer out there, you put them right in front of me, the two nice ladies and their song, it's not going to happen. There's not going to be any tears here today. But if there are tears here today, I have two gentlemen here armed with tissues. Thank you. I won't need them yet. Seniors, I need you to do one last thing for me. I need you to please rise. And I need you to recognize your parents for all the love and the support that they have given you all these years. Seniors, please rise. Parents, as I've reminded these students again and again, census data now shows that young adults up to the age of 34 are living with their parents in record numbers. So folks, it is not over yet. So why am I here, folks? Oh, you guys can sit, unless you want to keep standing, you know, we'll stretch it out a little bit. You know. No takers. I'm here today because of actually what my parents taught me, gratitude and attitude. I'm here today because this class rocks, and I'm one of your biggest fans. And I'm not alone in that fandom. Coach McKay agrees. He and I both independently wrote of you that you're one of the most selfless and teachable groups. And I know Superintendent Adams agrees. And let me put you on the spot, sir. Superintendent Adams, the class of 2015, great class or greatest class? I'm going to put you down for greatest. And if that does not work for you, if that does not impress you, think about this. Even Mr. Coakley said that he liked you guys. And he's out there somewhere. What he actually said, folks, was that he didn't hate you. But that is pretty close for him. So I want to showcase some gratitude and attitude and tell you why this class is so loved. Thank you, 2015, for being the kind of group that has a sincere interest in learning. For so many classes, students are obsessed, and this may surprise you, with IPass and with grades. That's not true of 2015. I cannot stress this enough. You cared about content and knowledge, and that mattered to me. Information wasn't just something that you could Google to temporarily understand. Information and knowledge was something to be valued. Thank you, 2015, for being the kind of class that kept buggering on, as the beautiful Winston Churchill might say. Let's face it, seniors. You lost hall decorating, you lost powder puff, and you even lost a tug of war against the freshmen. But whether it was our undefeated champion football team, my Euro group as sophomores who forced me to get the internet and Skype with you to keep up with the snow days, or a livid girls softball team who came back after a shutout last year, you demonstrated one of the most important human qualities, determination. With everything I asked of you, there was no pushback. even when my F period class, my fabulous F period class, groaned that I was going to make them work one last period on a really hot Friday. I barely even needed to drop a Churchill quote before one young lady stepped it up, banged her hands on her desk, and said, "Let's do this." And to this day, I don't know, and you know who you are. I don't know if you were making fun of me, but I did not care. I used your energy, and we got the job done. You gave me everything I asked for, class. When I asked you to step up out of your shells and do the footloose lip dub, you did it. You modeled school spirit. When I asked you to jump up on stage at the talent show and dance to "We're All in This Together," you did it all too willingly. Of course, I really need to thank the crew behind some of those projects, including the video that we're about to watch after this event. I know all too well from you people that if I did not thank these folks that were the crew that I worked with so much, that I would just end up being the subject of some ridiculous meme campaign on social media, which Keith is working on right now. When my wife asked me what really set the class of 2015 apart, I pointed her to a characteristic so universally simple that it could be found in one of our son's favorite movies, which we watch more than he does, Pixar's 1995 film, Toy Story. What I love about Toy Story is watching Andy's group of wonderfully vibrant and terribly flawed toys interact. Sheriff Woody's overdramatic realism, for example, is really nothing without Buzz Lightyear's delusions of grandeur. Central theme of Toy Story, of course, is that regardless of the differences in personality, what really matters most are the bonds of friendship. And that basic concept that we together are something greater than some of us separate and apart. And to me, that's you guys. Your positivity, your inclusivity, your legitimately friendly approach to everyone that I've ever seen you interact with, that's what sets you apart. You supported each other at every turn. You had Clocker fans for every possible sporting event and theatrical production. You were kind to others, a theme that we've heard over and over again. And if I'm repetitive, if I'm saying the same thing over again, it's because it's so true. You are so friendly. Even your outliers, those wonderfully antagonistic debaters, and those obnoxiously sassy students, and you know who you are. Even these seniors won people over easily. You generally accepted people's differences, and even when you disagreed on issues, you did not allow that to get in the way of personal friendship. I've seen some of you practically screaming at each other over which movie was better, Tangled or Frozen. And I've seen NPR diehards argue it out with Fox News aficionados to the brink of awkward, and yet somehow still hug it out when it was all over. Your class's inclusionary nature was inspiring. Even when we did every extra project together, you consistently made sure that you were asking the question, are we including everyone? And I think that's a wonderful model for this next generation before us. Finally, one of the reasons why your class stands out for me is because you got the importance of being positive. My parents drilled positivity into me, and we now do that to our boys. And in these last moments, I actually want to talk to you about my aunt, who modeled gratitude and positive attitude throughout her entire life, despite facing struggles for which, as a child, I was not even aware. As a director for women's athletics at a major university, my aunt faced sexism and favoritism regularly. And as a gay American, my aunt faced a society that rejected her simply for who she was and who she loved. All my life, this woman faced discrimination that I have never had to face. And in her last decade, she had to deal with a painful cancer that returned with a vengeance. Yet despite all these reasons, despite all the reasons to be spiteful, to be negative, to be discouraged, to be bitter, she was one of the happiest people I've ever known. I had the opportunity to speak to her just 2 days before she died. In October of 2012, when you were sophomores, and you made my day that day, and you don't even know it. I was so afraid for that call. Because even as we together recognized that our shared moments were at an end, she reminded me of all the wonderful times that we shared together. And with dignity, she modeled for me the concepts of gratitude and attitude and taught me how to say a proper goodbye. That's why I'm here. I want to thank you, and I want you to leave today grateful. Grateful for all that we have done in this building together. I want you to leave optimistic about what comes next. Because this commencement is but the beginning for you folks. Certainly it's an ending of your time here in this building, of a youth largely sheltered, but it's absolutely not the end of your education, and is most certainly the beginning of your life's journey. When I was your age, I had not yet visited the Great Pyramids of Egypt, nor gone scuba diving, nor gone to Hawaii, nor met my wife, or had the children that I love to go home to every day. When I graduated high school, so many of the most important and defining moments of my life were in the future. I had no idea they were going to happen. And yet, looking back now, I can see I was taking steps all along the way to make those moments a reality, to make my wonderful family a reality. You have so much to look forward to. Life will reward you richly with happy occasions, but it'll also test you with challenging and often sorrowful moments. And at all times, if you can keep buggering on, if you can KBO, if you can be positive and be grateful for what you have, you will find that your life is ever more enjoyable and more wondrous. I hope that your life is everything that you want it to be. If he wasn't going to cry, you knew I was. I'm just saying. May your life be everything you want it to be. May you be happy, may you be safe, and may the Force be with you all, always.
Thank you, Mr. Worcester. At this time, I would ask senior members of the band to please join the band for one last performance. Thank you. While we wait for members of the band to return to their seats, I wanted to take a moment to explain the yellow ribbons that many members of the class and faculty and guests are wearing. On Friday, member of the class, Emma Pignoni, Emma, would you stand up? Shared these ribbons with her classmates and those in attendance. These ribbons represent support for people with Down syndrome. And as Emma said on Friday, she has always felt so loved and respected by the Ashland community. And we are grateful for her and what she has done for us. And at this time, we will begin the presentation of scholarships and awards, and I invite members of the Ashland Business Association to the stage.
Good afternoon. I'm Leslie Marcy. I'm the former president of the Ashland Education Foundation, and joining me is Bill Gath from Realty Executives. We are on the scholarship committee for the Ashland Business Association. The ABA scholarship is focused on seniors that are great students, but that also exemplify outstanding community service. And this year we have some fantastic news. Due to the contributions made by the following ABA members, Bill Gath, Anne Marie's Dance Center, Needham Bank, Adam Sachs, and Tricia Kendall, we've been able to increase the amount of the scholarship award to two $1,500 scholarships. This is fantastic news. Thank you. Our first winner is a student that scored all sixes on a grading scale of 1 to 5. This person is a great all-around student, a leader in both the schools and in the community. Her essay that was part of the application was focused about on teaching local businesses how to expand using social media and having high school students volunteer to teach business owners how to achieve this, an idea that really connects students to local businesses. And as we just learned, this person also received the I Award for involvement. So I would like to congratulate Anna Weisgarber.
I've been privileged to be involved with the scholarship program for a number of years, and I must say that you seniors every year make it difficult for us to decide who to get an award. If we had our choice, we'd give you each a scholarship, but we just can't do that. The other young lady that received a scholarship was involved in 8 theatrical productions with the Ashland High School. She also, on weekends, was a music teacher and teacher aide to autistic children. This award goes to Brittany Krasner.
On behalf of the board and staff of WACA-TV, I want to congratulate the class of 2015 on their graduation and wish them the best of luck in all their future endeavors. We have 5 scholarships to give out today in no particular order. The first I'd like to present is to Toyin Youssef. Next, I would like to give it to her mirror image, Toby Youssef. The next young lady I've known ever since she's been a teeny tot, and I just want to congratulate her especially, Caroline Priest. The next young lady I've also known since she's been a small child. And big congratulations to her as well, Rachel Euless. Last but not least, Todd Carter.
On behalf of the Ashland Fire Department Association, congratulations, class of 2015. I'm here to present 5 scholarships from the association. The first 4 will be in memory of William Donnell's Memorial Scholarship. First one is Mitchell Cools. Second one is Richard Ferrazzi. Next is Anna Weisgerber. My 4th one is Caitlin Murray. The scholarship is in memory of William Fuller, the William Fuller Memorial Scholarship that goes to Curtis Roby.
Congratulations to the graduating class of 2015. I just finished, I think it's like 55 years ago I graduated high school. I'd be afraid to even think where my class yearbook went or what I was thinking would happen to me. But anyway, I am the current president of the Ashland Lions Club, and in 2 weeks I get to hand that over to my first vice president. We actually give out 4 awards every year, 4 scholarships. This year we actually gave one out to Keefe Tech. It has to be somebody who lives in Ashland. The other we gave to an Ashland student at Marion High. And I'm delighted to say that we have 2 students today that I want to give these out. These are both Memorial Scholarships. The first one was the Harry Hinchey Memorial Scholarship. And we are giving that one to Michaela Morse. The second one we're giving to Vanessa Cefalo. And Vanessa had been president of the Ashland Lions Leo Club this year.
Hello, I'm Kathy Silva, the Director of Student Services for Ashland Public Schools, and it is my honor and privilege to be able to award 10 scholarships that are given through the efforts of the Ashland Parent Advisory Council. These students have worked very hard, and hopefully the scholarship will help them in their efforts towards furthering their education and careers. The first recipient, Ms. Lauren Dummer. Ms. Adrian Corrales. Mr. George Tisigris. Ms. Caroline Priest. Ms. Courtney Ryan. Ms. Samantha Hebb. Ms. Veronica Lovely. Mr. Jacob Komisar. Ms. Molly Curis. And finally, Ms. Sky Griffin.
Good afternoon, all. I'm Officer Brian Jewett with the Ashland Police Department. On behalf of the Ashland Police Association, I'd like to take this opportunity and congratulate the class of 2015. Great job and good luck in all future endeavors. The Ashland Police Association would like to recognize two students with our yearly scholarship awards. The first scholarship recipient is Sophia Alberini. And the second scholarship recipient is presented to Emily Murray.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Robert Thacker, and for the 28th consecutive year, it's my privilege and honor to present the scholarships made possible by our generous and loyal members of the Ashland Scholarship Foundation. And the recipients this year are, in no particular order, Kristen Esposito. Derek Nash. Jacqueline Pease. Nicholas Bocelli. Catherine Spielberger. Daniel Kamerman Glick. And each year our highest award is named after James J. Reynolds. Jim Reynolds was a teacher here at Ashland High School. He was also an athletic coach, coached football among other sports. He was also the assistant principal, and he was also ended his career as principal of Ashland High School over a long career of over 35 years. So Jim Reynolds was a guy that gave everything in his life to Ashland High School, and it gave it everything he could. And in that spirit, the scholarship in his name goes to a student who exemplified those traits of Jim Reynolds and giving everything she could to Ashland High School, and one of the finest students ever at Ashland High School, Emily Cooper.
Good afternoon, congratulations. Class of 2015, you should all be very proud of yourselves. Just to echo Mr. Worcester's comments, truly a kind group, have accomplished a great deal, and I look forward to following all of you in the future, as well as seeing you when you return to Ashland High School. This year's senior scholar athlete recipients epitomize what we have come to expect from our student athletes here at Ashland High School. They have excelled on the field and in the gym, compiling individual accolades, as well as helping their teams reach new heights as Tri-Valley League champions and tournament qualifiers. Additionally, both of these students rank in the top tier academically in their class. This year's male recipient is a member of the National Honor Society and a three-sport varsity athlete in football, track, and baseball. His coaches describe him as a genuine young man who carries himself with great integrity. To quote his football coach, he is without a doubt the definition of what we want out of our student athletes. In the fall, this young man will take his talents to Worcester Polytechnic Institute and continue to play football. This year's scholar athlete male recipient is Brian Mahan. This year's female recipient has excelled on the soccer field, on the hardwood, and on the lacrosse field for the Clockers. In addition to maintaining a top 10 class ranking while taking a very demanding academic schedule, this young lady has been a member of the National Honor Society and the Senior Peer Leadership Group. Even during moments of adversity, she has demonstrated leadership, poise, and a commitment to doing what is best for her teammates and classmates. Her soccer coach says she was able to bring a level of commitment and maturity as captain that allowed us to compete each and every day in the TVL. I cannot thank her enough. In the fall, she will be attending either Northeastern, Syracuse, or UMass Amherst. This year's scholar athlete female recipient is Cassidy Firth.
I'm Mary Lou Hunt, and I'm here to present the 9th annual award of the Gene and Jerry Driscoll Scholarship. Although the Driscoll scholarships never had, the Driscolls never had any children, they were very interested in education and the Ashland school system. When they passed, they left more than $250,000 to be set aside for scholarships fund for the students of Ashland. The criteria that Driscoll set forth for eligibility for these scholarships were academic achievement, participation in co-curricular activities, and especially community service. I am pleased to award this year's scholarship to Michaela Morse.
It is with great pleasure that I get to announce publicly again for the second time our valedictorian and salutatorian with the Henry Warren Benevolent Fund Scholarship of $5,000. I would please ask that Ani Moore stand. As I read a class day, it is with great pleasure that I get to introduce the class of 2015's salutatorian, Ms. Ani Moore. Ani has attended the Ashland schools from kindergarten through grade 12 and has consistently been viewed by teachers, coaches, and administrators alike as a class act. For the past 4 years, Ani has consistently demonstrated her intelligence, work ethic, and the core values of what it truly means to be an Ashland High School Clocker. Ani is always respectful to herself and to others, showing deference to faculty and staff, and treating her peers with value and kindness. She has consistently demonstrated responsibility, both inside of the classroom with her consistently tireless work ethic, as well as outside of the classroom as president of the student council and captain of the cross country and track teams. She is a young woman with impeccable integrity, consistently doing the right things. Ani is a clocker who is involved in her school community with clubs and organizations like Student Council, working at the farmer's market, participating in three sports, basketball, cross country, and track, while being involved in academic groups such as the National Honor Society. She is truly a student athlete. Her involvement is particularly well-rounded. And lastly, and perhaps most especially, Ani has demonstrated achievement for which she is being recognized today as the class salutatorian. Ani has worked hard to put together this exemplary academic record. Her cumulative grade point average for the past 4 years is 4.579. She has taken one of the most challenging course loads a student at Ashland High School can possibly take and has thrived in the face of this challenge. Ani will be attending the University of Virginia in the fall to study biochemistry with hopes of applying this knowledge to the research field. I'd like to congratulate Ani. Like Ani, Anna is a proud graduate of all of our schools here in Ashland. She is a wonderful young woman who has clearly made a difference at Ashland High School. Anna consistently demonstrates Ashland High School's core values of respect, integrity, involvement, responsibility, and achievement in all that she does. She is a self-disciplined, hard-working student who is passionate about education and learning, if you didn't notice by her speech. She has been described by faculty as logical, a quick thinker, and a person who is always willing to share her knowledge and teach others. Anna's particular interests lay in the fields of math and elementary education. She is a mature, compassionate student and citizen. She is a natural leader who is focused on achieving her goals. She spends much of her time tutoring peers after school in the math wing, and she feels comfortable working with all of these students. She is a natural teacher and shares her talents. Anna works at Warren in the EDP program as a teacher's aide and has done volunteer work with Ashland Farmers Market, where she planned and ran a kids' craft corner. She's president of the Academic Decathlon, and her team relies on her even temperament, calm approach, and high intelligence. In addition to all she does, she also finds time to practice Irish dance and handbells. Clearly, she is a well-rounded young lady. To quote a teacher, there's not a nicer individual than Anna. She's humble, kind, and values things such as her family, her religion, and her education. She's grounded and knows how to balance things in her life and prioritize the parts that really matter. She's always willing to try new things and looks for challenges whenever possible. Clearly, it goes without saying, Anna is a powerful student who has taken one of the most rigorous course loads here, ending her wonderful career with a GPA over 5. Yeah, pretty impressive on a 4.0 scale. Anna's the winner of the Wellesley Book Award. She's received numerous course discipline awards from AP Euro to AP Statistics. She was a commended student in the National Merit Scholarship Program. Anna will be attending Michigan State on a full scholarship and was awarded the university's Distinguished Scholarship. And I'd like to read this from Michigan State. The University Distinguished Scholarship is the most prestigious academic scholarship offered by Michigan State University. The scholarship covers the cost of tuition, room and board, and a stipend for up to 8 semesters of undergraduate education, currently worth over $200,000 for non-Michigan students. The University Distinguished Scholars participate in the programs of the Unique Honors College at MSU, in addition to academic work in their major or majors, and receive a paid undergraduate research assistantship in a field of their choice. The University Distinguished Scholarships, initiated in 2000, are targeted towards students whose exceptional academic records require an early competitive scholarship response from Michigan State. Distinguished scholars are selected by a committee comprised of the provost, the director of admissions, and the Dean of the Honors College. Only eight, let me repeat that, eight University Distinguished Scholarships were offered this year as a result of the selection process from an MSU application pool of more than 32,000 students and approximately 7,800 freshmen. Quite an accomplishment for sure. While Michigan State is justifiably proud of all its students, it is particularly exciting and rewarding that such an accomplished student as Anna has selected Michigan State for their undergraduate education. As for future plans, she intends to double major in elementary education, statistics, and minor in economics. Her goal is to graduate in 3 years and then do a full year internship in a school while taking graduate classes, then get a master's and teach elementary school, hopefully in first grade, as she's written to me. And what I will say is this, in 4 years, please give me a call and we'll work something out. So it is with much pleasure that I introduce Anna Assenther as our valedictorian.
On behalf of my husband and family, it gives me great pleasure to be here today in memory of our son and brother to honor students in his name. Kevin died on August 31st, 1998 due to an extremely rare form of cancer caused by a toxic waste site in the town of Ashland. Due to his appeals to the state and federal government, the completion of the project was provided and the site is now free of deadly chemicals. During the month of April, each year we hold a spring fling. To honor Kevin's memory. And over the past years, 17 to be exact, through the generosity of so many folks in this town and elsewhere, we have been able to raise sufficient funds to have awarded over $120,000 in scholarship money to over 100 graduates at Ashland High School and Tactical High School. Additionally, we provide a courageous award to an individual who has demonstrated courage in the face of adversity. This year's award was presented to a former faculty member at Ashland High School who is presently suffering with cancer. Our prayers are for a speedy and complete recovery. In addition to tonight's honorees, we have awarded seven $1,000 scholarships to students at Keefe High School in Framingham. Of the four applicants we received from this year's graduating class, we have selected two outstanding students. Please come forward, Natasha Ballas. And Michaela Morse.
Good afternoon. On behalf of President Joseph Aoun and the members of the Board of Trustees, I would like to congratulate the class of 2015. We are in the process of offering two scholarships this year. Fortunately, we have two recipients that will take these. These are worth approximately $100,000 apiece. And this particular year, this will push the scholarship program here in the Ashland community over $2 million from Northeastern University. I would like to congratulate them personally, and I would like Emily Murray to come up, please. If they're not upstage, Mr. Quigley. Door number three, Cassidy Firth. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My sisters and I are pleased to award two Penelope Ellis Ashland High School Memorial Scholarships. For the past 18 years, we've granted these scholarships in memory of our mother, Penelope Ellis, who taught here at Ashland High School for over 34 years. It is in honor of her passion for the sciences, for teaching, and her love of Ashland High School that we grant the first award to Mr. Jacob Komisar. And the second award to Ms. Ani Kim.
Oh, sorry.
Ani Moore, I apologize.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am delighted to be here along with Steve Mitchell as members of the Board of Selectmen and representing the Board of Selectmen. First and foremost, we'd like to congratulate the class of 2015. You're almost ready to take a big breath and it's almost over. But your journey's not completed, it's just starting. We are extremely honored to stand here this afternoon representing the entire board. We honor two very worthy graduates for their outstanding community service to the town of Ashland, which is one of the major criterias for the Board of Selectmen scholarship. One of our major criterias, again, like I said, the graduate must show a level of community service above and beyond the standard required hours. These two graduates rose to the top. We're very proud to present the second annual Board of Selectmen scholarships to these two very deserving students. Ladies first, Miss Sophia Alberini. And secondly, to Mr. Daniel Kunis. Thank you again.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Major Stellatano, and on behalf of Commanding Officer of Marine Corps Recruiting Station Portsmouth, I would like to thank the administration and faculty of Ashland High School for this opportunity to recognize a deserving young man. Each year, thousands of young men and women apply for a scholarship in the Marine Corps Naval Reserve Officer Training Corps. This year, only 7 high school seniors from Maine, New Hampshire, and Massachusetts were receiving this scholarship in order to attend the college of their choice. From New Jersey and Pennsylvania all the way through our country's northern border with Canada, less than 70 scholarships were awarded out of thousands of impressive applications. It is a true testament of hard work and dedication to the staples of academics, athletics, and local community involvement that this scholarship is being awarded here today. This scholarship is worth over $180,000. But more importantly, it provides an incredible opportunity to a young, driven American that surmounts all financial reward. The opportunity to attend college while developing a real-life leadership and managerial skills is second in importance only to the dedication to service in defense of America's values and freedoms. On behalf of the Commandant of the Marine Corps, General Joseph Dunford, I would like to present this year's Naval Reserve Officer Training Corps Scholarship to Mr. John Van Cleef, Jr.
It is a privilege and honor to now present the Sean Hanrahan Memorial Ashland Youth Basketball Scholarships. These two recipients both finished a tremendous career here this past winter for Ashland High School. Most importantly, though, these recipients, throughout the course of their 4 years here, continued to give back to youth basketball, the organization that helped them up through the ranks along the way. This year's recipients, Marissa Walsh and Cam Faniff.
Thank you and congratulations to all the award and scholarship recipients. At this time, I invite Lee Mansfield to perform I Hope You Dance, and accompanied by Grace Lee.
Sense of wonder, get your fill to eat, but always keep that hunger. May you never take one single breath for granted. God forbid love ever leaves you empty-handed. I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you never mountains in the distance. Never settle for the path of least resistance. Living might mean taking chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some hell-bent heart leave you bitter. If you come close to selling out, reconsider. Give the heavens above more than just a passing glance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you sip feels all. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, dance, I hope you dance. 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 And I pray you dance. And I hope you dance.
And Grace, thank you. Okay, class of 2015, it is time. Kitsia. Right, Mr. McGann, we need you.
Anna Carolyn Essenther.
Anna would like to thank her teachers, family, and friends for their support and encouragement. She will be attending Michigan State University, where she will study education statistics.
Ani Carolina Moore.
Ani would like to thank her parents for their endless support. She will be attending the University of Virginia in pursuit of conducting scientific research.
Emily Perry Cooper.
Emily would like to thank her parents for their unconditional love and support, her sister for her encouragement, and her friends for all the memories. She will be attending UMass Amherst and majoring in nursing.
Emily Oliver Murray.
Emily would like to thank her entire family as well as church family for their steadfast love, trust, and encouragement of her faith. She would also like to thank Mr. McGann for walking alongside her for the past 4 years. She will be attending Northeastern University in hopes of becoming a pediatric doctor one day.
Sophia Poirier.
Sophia would like to thank her family, friends, and coaches for their unconditional support. She will be playing lacrosse and studying chemical and biomedical engineering at UMass Lowell.
Cassidy Amber Firth.
Cassidy would like to thank her family and friends for their constant love and support. She will be attending Northeastern University in the fall to study engineering.
Natalia Rodriguez Cordero.
Natalia would like to thank her parents for their support. She will be attending UMass Amherst in the fall.
Marissa Catherine Walsh.
Marissa would like to thank her grandparents and loved ones for their unwavering support and loyalty. She will be majoring in biochemistry on a pre-med track and is currently deciding between Wake Forest and UMass Amherst.
Donald Sherrod York.
Donald would like to thank his parents for their constant support. He will be attending George Washington University where he plans to major in chemistry.
Grace Caroline Lee.
Grace would like to thank God, her family, and friends for inspiring her to work hard. Grace will be attending the United States Naval Academy.
Lee Grant Mansfield.
Lee would like to thank his parents, sister, and brother. He will be attending the American Musical and Dramatic Academy to become a pioneer in musical theater.
Helen Victoria Siagres.
Helen would like to thank her mother and father for their love and support. She will be attending the College of the Holy Cross to study biology.
Anna Elizabeth Weisgerber.
Anna would like to thank her parents for being the best parents ever and always encouraging her, and Mr. Worcester for pushing her academically and knowing her Disney references. She will be majoring in international relations at Boston College.
Benjamin Kendrick Barrett.
Ben would like to thank his parents. He will be attending Georgetown University.
Haley Virginia Blakemore.
Haley would like to thank her friends and family for their support. She will be studying biology at Clark University.
Nicholas Augustine Bocelli.
Nick would like to thank his mom, dad, and the squad. He will be attending UMass Amherst and will one day become a shark on Shark Tank.
Kyle John Booth.
Kyle would like to thank his dad, mom, the squad, and Mr. Worcester. He will be attending The Ohio State University.
Stephanie Lynn Ciccarelli.
Stephanie would like to thank her parents for their constant support and encouragement. She will be attending Wheaton College.
Emily Amanda Dunn.
Emily would like to thank her mom and dad for dealing with her and Mr. Worcester for always going to bat for her. She will be attending Colby College on a pre-law track.
Kristen Jean Esposito.
Kristen would like to thank her parents for their love and support and Ms. McMahon for helping her through the college search. She will be studying biomedical engineering at the University of Connecticut.
Libby Marie Farrell.
Libby would like to thank her mom, dad, and Nora for being supportive through the years. She will be attending UMass Amherst School of Business.
Colin Charles Finnegan.
Colin would like to thank his mom, dad, and his Lord and Savior, George Steinbrenner. He plans on living the American dream.
Ashley Troy Fisher.
Ashley would like to thank her mom and dad for all their encouragement and support. She will be attending the University of Connecticut.
Miguel Angel Franco.
Miguel would like to thank his parents and teachers, especially his science teachers. He will be attending UMass Amherst and will go on to medical school in the pursuit to become an anesthesiologist.
Lauren Reese Grasberger.
Lauren would like to thank her family and friends. She will be attending Clarkson University studying civil engineering.
Etana Ray Handelman.
Etana would like to thank her parents. She will be majoring in biology at UMass Amherst.
Daniel Cameraman Glick.
Dan would like to thank his family, the squad, and the lunch ladies. He will be attending the Berklee College of Music and plans to become a musician.
Erin Catherine Keaveney.
Erin would like to thank her mom, dad, and sisters for being the best people ever. She will be attending Villanova University.
Jacob Elias Commissar.
Jacob would like to thank Mrs. Benham, Mr. Worcester, Mr. Ward, Joseph, his friends and family, and the Academy. He will be attending WPI to study bioinformatics.
Brittany Claire Krasner.
Brittany will be attending Connecticut College.
Megan Alyssa Leon.
Megan would like to thank her mom and dad for supporting her in her dreams. She will be attending Ithaca College, where she will study marketing and communications.
Brian Stephen Mahan.
Brian would like to thank his family, Coach McKay, Coach Messer, and the squad. He will be attending WPI to become an engineer.
Alexander James Merloney.
Alex would like to thank his mom and dad for all their support. He will be studying criminal justice in college.
Nicole Catherine Merloney.
Nikki would like to thank her parents for being her biggest supporters. She will be attending Marist College and hopes to become a buyer.
James Robert Miller.
James would like to thank his parents, family, and friends. He will be attending Quinnipiac University to study business.
Michaela Ashley Morse.
Michaela would like to thank her parents and teachers for always motivating her to work her hardest. She will be attending Stonehill College to major in elementary education and become an elementary school teacher.
Caitlin Brooke Murray.
Caitlin would like to thank her parents for their love and support. She will be studying nursing at Worcester State University.
Derek Peter Nash.
Derek would like to thank his papa and Don Miller. He will be attending Binghamton University.
Rachel Marissa Nielsen.
Rachel would like to thank her parents and sister for being her biggest supporters. She will be attending UMass Amherst to follow her dreams of becoming an elementary school teacher.
Kara Eblen O'Toole. Joseph Brian Parisi.
Joe would like to thank his mom, dad, and siblings for their love and support. He will be attending the University of Vermont and pursue a career in business.
Jacqueline Rita Pexi.
Jacqueline would like to thank her family. She will be studying exercise science at Ithaca College and will be on the swim team.
Emma Lynn Pignoni.
Emma would like to thank her teachers, family, and friends. She plans to continue on changing the world with her smile.
Justine Noelle Pitt.
Justine would like to thank her parents for loving and supporting her unconditionally. She will be studying nursing at the University of Rhode Island.
Curtis Joseph Roby.
Curtis would like to thank his parents for all their support throughout the years. He will be studying mechanical engineering at the University of Maine.
Brianna Grace Sarno.
Brianna would like to thank Ms. Shields and Ms. Cameron for being extremely supportive. She will be attending the Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts to study psychology and behavior analysis.
Rose Mary Shannon.
Rose would like to thank her incredible parents, her sister Farrell, her brothers, and most importantly, God. She will be attending Gordon College.
Robert Francis Shapiro.
Robert would like to thank his parents and teachers for always pushing him to do his best. He will be attending UMass Amherst with a major in mechanical engineering.
Valerie Rose Suchins.
Valerie would like to thank her family, friends, and all the teachers that she has had throughout the years. She plans to become a successful engineer.
Catherine Claire Spielberger.
Katie would like to thank her teachers, her supportive parents, and her friends and family. She will be attending the University of Dayton and will be studying elementary education.
Jordan Naomi Stone.
Jordan would like to thank her mom and dad for their endless love and support. She will be playing lacrosse at the College of Worcester in Ohio and majoring in business economics.
Morgan Mitchell Sunderland.
Morgan would like to thank her family for their support and her teachers for their dedication. She will be attending Florida Atlantic University to study dietetics.
Noah Richard Tagliaferri.
Noah would like to thank his family and school for the opportunities they have provided him. He will be deferring his acceptance to Northeastern University while pursuing service in the United States Marine Corps.
Marilyn Tellis.
Mindy would like to thank her parents for supporting her throughout these 4 years. She will be studying OBGYN nursing at Milligan College in Tennessee.
Lindsay Taylor Tolan.
Lindsay would like to thank her mom, dad, and brothers Ryan and Jake. She will be attending UMass Amherst.
Adam Philip Tomczak.
Adam would like to thank his parents for all their support. He will be majoring in marketing at James Madison University.
George Christos Siagras.
George would like to thank his mother Anita and his father Christos. He will be majoring in accounting at Bentley University.
John Fitzgerald Van Cleef.
John would like to thank his mom, dad, brothers, the squad, the Ashland High School faculty, and Mark Champagne. He will be attending Rutgers University.
Audrey Brooke Weiner.
Audrey would like to thank her parents, Sabrina, and her teachers. She will be attending Quinnipiac University in the School of Nursing with hopes of working in a neonatal intensive care unit in the future.
Gina Elizabeth Whitridge.
Gina would like to thank her family and all of her teachers. She will be studying psychology and continue figure skating.
Rebecca Catherine Winsek.
Rebecca would like to thank her parents and teachers for motivating her to work hard. She will be attending Emmanuel College for Elementary Education.
Zoe Alexandra Wood.
Zoe would like to thank her mom, dad, and sister Lily. She will be attending The Ohio State University.
Faridat Oluwatoyin Yusuf.
Toyin will be attending Northeastern University to study computer engineering.
Hassanat Oluwatobi Yusuf.
Toby would like to thank her parents and teachers for teaching her important knowledge. She will become a neurologist and doctor after attending Northeastern University.
Sophia Teresa Alberini.
Sophia would like to thank her parents and Ms. Hansen. She will be attending Worcester State University for criminal justice.
Carly Marie Baker.
Carly would like to thank her mom and teachers. She will be attending Bridgewater University and majoring in special education.
Corey Lynn Bennett.
Corey would like to thank her loving family and coach for always supporting her through the obstacles this crazy, beautiful life has thrown at her.
Joshua Ellis Biazzi.
Josh would like to thank his mother, Dale, and the base God he plans to live life.
Trisha Ann Bishop.
Trisha would like to thank her mom. She plans to be the best person she can be.
Annabella Bree Bonanno.
Bella would like to thank Mr. Parker for helping her throughout her high school career and Ms. Hansen for being the best.
Tony Michelle Bonaveri.
Tony would like to thank her family, friends, and Ms. Hansen.
Michael Richard Boudreau.
Mike would like to thank his family, friends, and Ms. Istefan. He will be attending Framingham State University.
Paul Richard Boudreau.
Paul would like to thank his parents, Julie and Sean Boudreau. He will be attending UMass Dartmouth, where he will major in business.
Thomas Paul Braun Jr.
TJ would like to thank his mother, the squad, Roberta, Peter, and the wonderful lunch ladies. He will be attending Massachusetts Bay College.
Benjamin Adam Butkus.
Ben would like to thank his friends, family, and his teachers, especially Mr. Moshevich, Mr. Mall, and Mr. Roman. He plans to make movies in his future.
Colin Robert Capistran.
Colin would like to thank his mom and dad. He plans on attending Quinn Sigmund College in the fall.
Claire Margaret Carlson.
Claire would like to thank her mom and dad. She plans to live a successful life.
Todd Timothy Carter.
Todd would like to thank his family, friends, and teachers. He will be attending Framingham State University for business management.
Vanessa Marie Cefalo.
Vanessa would like to thank her parents. She will be attending Fitchburg State University and majoring in business administration.
Michael Chung.
Michael would like to thank his family, friends, and awesome teachers at Ashland High School.
Leonardo Chicale.
Leonardo would like to thank his family for their support and also the new people that he met this year. He plans to finish his Italian high school next year.
Jessica Gillen Connors.
Jessie would like to thank her family and friends for their love and support. She plans to be successful in all that she does.
Alexander Michael Covell.
Alex would like to thank his mom and dad. He will be attending UMass Amherst.
Joseph John Krupe.
JJ would like to thank his mom, dad, and his friends. He will be attending the University of Rhode Island to become an entrepreneur.
Daniel William Kunis.
Danny would like to thank God and his family. He will be attending Mass Bay and to then transfer to a four-year university.
Victor Hugo Garcia Te Carvalho.
Victor would like to thank his friends, family, and Mrs. Walden for their support in his new environment.
Renan Jesus de Oliveira.
Renan would like to thank Ms. Walden, his mentor, Mr. Harrington, his mom, Anna, and his dad, Gene, and his grandparents, who are attending SUNY Purchase in New York to pursue his dreams of becoming a theatrical set designer.
Jose Augusto de Souza Neto.
Jose would like to thank his family for all their support. He will be majoring in psychology.
Lauren Mary Dummer.
Lauren would like to thank her parents, her friends, and her family. She will be attending Anna Maria College in the fall.
Mackenzie Lynn Dupre.
Mackenzie would like to thank her loving and supportive family. She will be attending Southern New Hampshire University under a contract with Northeastern with intent to transfer.
Catherine Manville Emberly.
Katie would like to thank her teachers and her family. She will be serving a year with the city and pursuing a career in special education.
Richard Michael Ferrazzi.
Richard would like to thank his family and friends who will be attending the University of Maine majoring in mechanical engineering.
Samantha Miranda Foster.
Samantha would like to thank her parents, family, and friends for their love and support. She will be attending the University of Rhode Island as a medical laboratory science major.
Ryan Jacob Fredericks.
Ryan would like to thank his family and friends.
Madison Lynn Fry.
Madison would like to thank her family for so much support. She hopes to become a licensed
Ephesus.
Madeline Rose Fuller.
Maddie would like to thank her family, friends, and Ms. Hansen. She will be attending Georgia Southern University for nursing.
Zane Knud Getman.
Zane would like to thank his parents and teachers for supporting him. He plans on graduating college and living comfortably.
Alisa Da Silva Gomes.
Alisa would like to thank her parents for always pushing her to be her best. She plans on becoming a child psychologist after studying at Florida Atlantic University.
Christopher Paul Goodwin.
Chris would like to thank everyone. He will be attending Framingham State University.
Sky Michaela Griffin.
Sky would like to thank her family and teachers. She will be attending Mass Bay Community College for 2 years and then transferring to a four-year college to one day become a nurse.
James Robert Hatch.
James would like to thank his mom and dad. He plans on becoming a professional slopestyle skier.
Samantha Jean Hebb.
Samantha would like to thank her family and teachers for all their support. She will be attending Castleton State College studying health science.
Nicholas Allen Hudson.
Nick would like to thank Mr. McGann for all his hard work and understanding. He will be going into business and starting his own company.
Michael Dimitri Kabazovsky.
Michael would like to thank his mom, Mr. Mostow, and his friends. He will be attending Keith Tech postgraduate program studying metal fabrication.
Adriana Rose Corrales.
Adriana would like to thank her mom and her dad for all their love and support. She'll be attending Assumption College in the fall, majoring in secondary education and history.
Sadicha Karki.
Sadicha would like to thank her family and Nicki Minaj. She will be attending NYU and studying dramatic writing.
Jake Robert Keating.
Jake would like to thank his mom and his dad. He will be attending University of New Hampshire, majoring in exercise science.
Mitchell Thomas Kalulis.
Mitchell would like to thank his family for always supporting him and his friends for always making him laugh. He will be studying communications at Roger Williams University.
Thomas Johannes Kirk.
Tom would like to thank his mom and dad.
Tyler James Kalowski.
Tyler would like to thank Mr. Smith for helping him with his hard artwork. He will be attending Mass Bay Community College next year.
Molly Angelina Curris.
Molly would like to thank her entire family for all the support they have given her and her best friends. She will be studying psychology at Bridgewater State University.
Stephen Michael Laspiza.
Stephen would like to thank his family, his scout troop, and his close friends. He will be attending Keith Tech postgraduate program for media and web development.
Jonathan Austin Libby.
John would like to thank his friends and family.
Jamie Elizabeth Love.
Jamie would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers. She will be attending Westfield State University.
Veronica Rose Lovely.
Veronica would like to thank her parents and special education teachers. She will be attending Mass Bay and then attending a four-year college to become a veterinary technician.
Francis Paul Lubega.
Francis would like to thank his family, Coach McKay, Mr. Seigels, and all his teachers. He will be attending WPI to become an engineer.
Catherine Hopkins Mahoney.
Katie would like to thank her mom and dad. She will be attending Wofford College as a business major.
Ian Michael Mazzoni.
Ian would like to thank Mr. Worcester. He'll be attending Mass Maritime Academy.
James Francis McCune.
James will be going to Mass Art for Film.
Maria Sophia Dorothy Mercoldi.
Maria would like to thank her parents and grandparents for giving her the chance to study in the United States for an entire year. She'll be going back to Italy, graduating from Italian high school and studying medicine.
Kyle Michael Maspelli.
Kyle would like to thank his mom and dad. He will be attending Quinsigamond College.
Joshua Allen Milne.
Josh would like to thank his mom, dad, brothers, and the squad. He will be attending University of Vermont.
Antonio Mitchens.
Antonio would like to thank his family. He will be attending UMass Dartmouth.
Lazaro Mitchens Jr.
Laz would like to thank his parents and for their support and the squad. He will be attending UMass Amherst.
Cole Daniel Monaco.
Cole would like to thank his mom and dad for their love and support. He plans on becoming a mechanical engineer.
Casey Sullivan Mott.
Casey would like to thank his parents for their support. He plans to make money.
Danielle Faye Muchnick.
Danielle would like to thank her family for their amazing support. She will be attending Mass Bay Community College for 2 years and then transferring to a university for physical therapy.
Max Austin Noe.
Max would like to thank all of the teachers and staff. He will be attending Wentworth Institute of Technology.
Matthew Patrick O'Brien.
Matt would like to thank his family. He'll be going to Keene State and plans to travel out west.
Malcolm Bradford Osborne III.
Malcolm would like to thank his family and Jesus. He will be attending Westfield State University.
Keith Lewis Palmieri.
Keith would like to thank the Academy, his mom, dad, the squad, and Michael Worcester. He plans to be the very best like no one ever was.
Karina Marie Palumbo.
Karina would like to thank her family and teachers. She will be attending Southern New Hampshire University, hoping to become a preschool teacher.
Catherine Adele Pellegrini.
Catherine would like to thank her teachers and friends for their support. She will be attending Westfield State University in the fall.
Robert Joseph Pergakis.
Robert would like to thank his aunt Karen and his grandmother Janet for everything they do. He will be attending Westfield State University to pursue a career in criminal justice.
Cameron Matthew Faniff.
Cam would like to thank Mr. Roman for being such a great mentor for him throughout both sports and academics. He hopes to graduate UMass Dartmouth with his master's degree in marketing and to be a successful businessman.
Leah Marks Plotkin.
Leah would like to thank her parents, grandparents, her brother Josh, and Taylor. She will be attending Southern New Hampshire University.
Caroline Stewart Priest.
Caroline would like to thank her family and her teachers. She will be attending Dean College and hopes to become a preschool special education teacher.
Brenna Mary Quinn.
Brenna would like to thank her mom, dad, and sister. She'll be majoring in biology at Coastal Carolina University.
Brittany Marie Raymond.
Brittany would like to thank her parents, her entire family, and everyone else who has supported her along the way. She will be attending University of Rhode Island, majoring in marine biology, and hopes to continue into veterinary school.
Cassandra Bonita Rodriguez.
Cassandra would like to thank her parents and Ms. Cameron for the support. She will be pursuing a career in criminal justice.
Suellen Riesla Rodriguez de Oliveira.
Suellen would like to thank her family and the AHS staff for all their support. She will be attending Worcester State University in hopes of becoming a physician's assistant.
Dylan John Rovers.
Dylan would like to thank his grandfather and his parents. He will be attending Franklin Pierce University and majoring in health sciences.
Sheldon James Rowland.
Sheldon would like to thank Ms. Daly. He hopes to become a history teacher one day.
Courtney Patricia Ryan.
Courtney would like to thank all of her teachers, her parents, friends, and family. She will be attending Fitchburg State University studying early childhood education.
Julian Edward Soleil.
Julian would like to thank the Academy, David Merrick, and the man downstairs.
Jared Joseph Sarno.
Jared would like to thank all the incredible staff at AHS. He will be attending UMass Lowell and continue to pursue his passion in music.
Patrick Sinclair Sarsgaard.
Patrick would like to thank his mother, Deborah, for always pushing him further. He plans on attending college and being happy.
Bogdan Igorovich Sherbina.
Bogdan would like to thank his parents, his little brother, and the Fornese family. He will be attending the Massachusetts Maritime Academy for Marine Transportation.
Francis Mary Sheehy.
Francis would like to thank all the people she has met throughout high school. She hopes to become a biologist and do something big.
Devin Samuel Sheff.
Devin would like to thank his family, friends, the squad, and Mr. Roman. He'll be attending Framingham State University as a part-time student majoring in business.
Rayanne Alandra Smith.
Rayanne would like to thank her parents for all their support and unconditional love. She'll be attending Broward College majoring in engineering.
Robert Luca Smith.
Robert would like to thank his parents, Kathy and Kelly, for their love and support. He'll be attending Fordham University in New York City studying in marketing.
William David Soldi.
William would like to thank his parents, friends, teachers, doctors, and lawyers. He'll be attending Bryant University majoring in international business.
William Bond Sullivan.
William would like to thank his parents and all his teachers at AHS. He is planning to move somewhere warm and to get rich.
Madison Catherine Temple.
Maddie would like to thank her family and best friends for being the bomb for the past 4 years. She'll be attending the University of New Haven, studying chemistry, and spending her first semester in Prato, Italy.
Matthew Ronald Tose.
Matt would like to thank his family and friends, his plans on being successful.
Lacey Ann Trevoloni.
Lacey would like to thank her family and all of her teachers. She will be attending Worcester State University with hopes of becoming a pediatric nurse.
Rachel Lauren Euless.
Rachel would like to thank her mom and dad for all their love and support. She will be attending University of New Hampshire with a major in health management and policy.
Natasha Katrina Vallis.
Natasha would like to thank her parents. She will be attending Loyola University of Maryland, majoring in biology.
Angelis Bonita Vegija.
Angie would like to thank her friends and family for all the support they have shown. She will be pursuing her dreams of photography.
Eric Mitchell Wallace.
Eric would like to thank his mom and dad. He plans to make you proud and to make money.
Tyler Paul Wilkinson.
Tyler would like to thank his parents and classmates. He will be attending Plymouth State University.
Kitsy, I would now like the entire class of 2015 to rise. Do it anyway. Having met all of the graduation requirements set forth by the Ashland Public Schools, I ask you to take your tassels and move them to the left side. In doing so, I now pronounce you the 142nd graduated class of Ashland High School. Now you can cue the music.